CO2 laser, a tool many desire for their home shop. I recently received the BMO by Flux. It's a compact machine with 30 watts of cutting and engraving power that starts selling at around $1,500. Let's see if it's worth its price tag and what I was able to do with that amount of energy. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. I have plenty of 3D printers in my home shop, together with a CNC router and even two diode laser engravers. The one piece of equipment that I wanted to have is a CO2 laser cutter, because it allows you to cut and mark a large variety of materials without a lot of setup and with only minimum mess. For this reason, I was really happy when the company Flux reached out to me and offered me one of their latest CO2 laser cutters for review. The BMO is the most compact laser cutters that Flux offers. The concept of the BMO is that it's compact but still capable. It comes shipped in a single box and can easily be handled. The box contains the machine itself that has everything you need to set it up on its inside, including a vent hose that guides the process fumes away from the machine. The included user manual doesn't only look nice from the outside, but also guides you through the whole setup process over software, materials, maintenance and troubleshooting. I was really looking for a nice peel off the big protective sheet on the front. Unfortunately, I was a bit disappointed that it stuck almost too well. Okay, jokes aside. BMO uses only a reasonable 615mm by 445mm on your desk, feels nice and sturdy with its sheet metal construction, comes with pre-aligned laser mirrors and includes everything you need to run it. For a CO2 laser, that's not only the laser tube itself, but also a water cooling system and an air pump for air assist. Air assist is basically compressed air that comes out of the laser nozzle and cleans the cut you are working on from smoke and debris for better cutting and engraving results. Speaking of cooling, I had to add a couple of milliliters of distilled water into the reservoir because it was a bit low, so that I heard bubbles going through the system. The clear safety cover includes a switch that won't let the laser turn on if it's open, so no safety goggles are required during operation. The usable working area is 300mm by 210mm, so the size of an A4 or letter size piece of paper, so not too big. On the base of the working chamber is a honeycomb mesh on which you place your workpiece. It's removable for cleaning and the bottom can even be removed if you, for example, plan to buy the rotary add-on for working on round objects. They use linear rails for the X-axis and sturdy smooth rods for the Y-axis, which is pretty nice. The only thing I don't really like is the belt system, where 3D printers have matured a lot over the last years and where Flux should probably get a bit inspired. First, the belt is not entirely parallel, which is not a huge problem, but might lead to minor distortions in the outer regions of the bed. Then there is the idler that's out of plastic. It can be tightened, but that would require removing two side panels. It's not the best solution, and if I feel my belt, it might be good to tighten it just a little more. The laser needs to be focused on the object you're working on. In order to do that, you swing down the focus arm, loosen the focus ring, slide everything up or down until the bar rests on the workpiece, and tighten the focus ring again. Pretty simple and straightforward. At last, there's a big fan in the back that quickly removes the smoke from the process area and vents it through a 120mm exhaust. Speaking of exhausting, I also received the Beam Air because my initial plan was to place the BMO in my studio. German houses are quite well insulated, so exhausting outside is more challenging than you might think. The Beam Air is a 4-stage air filter, consisting out of a pre-filter, medium filter, a charcoal filter and a beefy H13 HEPA filter, with a goal to get particles and odors out of the process air. That should allow you to use the laser without the need to vent to the outside. The design is clean and compact and it can either be operated manually or, in my case, if I connect it to the BMO, it will automatically turn on when the laser operates. The fumes are guided through a flexible hose that you connect between the laser cutter and the fume extractor. Unfortunately, I quickly moved my BMO back to the basement to vent to the outside, because for my application the Beam Air is not right, but I'll get to that in a bit. Setup of the BMO laser engraver is really simple using a nice color touchscreen. You either connect the machine via Ethernet or using the included Wi-Fi adapter to your network. Beam Studio, the software used to create the laser projects, is available for Windows, macOS and Linux. It's also nice to see that the software is actively developed, with the most recent version only being a couple of days old. Beam Studio is very easy to use and includes plenty of presets for different materials. You got basic shapes for designing simple parts, but also have the option to import external vector formats like SVG or DXF. You can arrange your projects on different layers to assign individual parameters and also set the order in which your design gets processed, because you, for example, want to first engrave and then cut out your part. Besides vector engraving and cutting, where the laser follows the line, also raster engraving can be performed. Raster engraving is used when you don't only want the outline of your part, but if you want to remove a bigger area, or if you want to etch a grayscale image on your workpiece. In that mode, the laser head travels in a narrow, meandering pattern, and the laser is modulated so that it quickly turns on and off to only mark the desired areas. By also modulating the laser power, you can even engrave grayscale images. This can be done with JPEG images, for example. Another great feature is the included camera that scans your working area so that you can precisely align and position your designs. But how does the BMO laser cutter actually perform? Having only experience with diode laser engravers in the past, I was really pleased with the results. Since I wanted to find out what I can process with the machine, I lasered out a good dozen of material cutting tests with a pre-made pattern that's available in Beam Studio. Every rectangle corresponds to one laser power, actually percent laser power of the maximum 30 watts, and cutting speed in millimeters per second. The softer 4mm popular plywood that you can find in any German hardware store cuts like butter, even at higher speeds, in only one pass. I even was able to cut 8mm thick plywood using two passes. Balsa wood, probably especially interesting for model airplane builders, cuts with no issues at 4mm really cleanly, and even 10mm worked mostly well. So here we can see that it's a good idea to find proper cutting parameters, because maximum energy can sometimes just lead to your workpiece catching fire instead of cutting. I had the impression that going faster is usually the better choice for nicer results, and rather using two passes. Also a neat trick on the side, if you want to cut thicker materials, set your focus that it's slightly below the surface, maybe even going to half of the thickness, because that will lead to a more even energy density over the cut. Where the 30 watt laser starts struggling a little is if you want to cut harder wood. 2.5 mm and 4mm birch plywood still cut well at a bit lower speeds, but 6.5 mm is just too much, even at multiple passes. Here, you rather start burning the wood than cutting it. Cardboard, of course, no issues whatsoever. 4mm felt, not a problem. 6mm Dapron foam board that I used in the past for my model airplanes cuts great even at higher speeds and reduced laser power. The cool thing about CO2 laser cutters is that you can work on transparent materials. The wavelength of a CO2 laser is around 10,600 nanometers, which is 20 times higher than blue laser diodes, for example. Things that are transparent in the visible spectrum are often not transparent for light at this high wavelength. Therefore, the laser energy is getting absorbed in the material and so can be used for cutting and engraving. Unfortunately, the thinnest piece I had in my shop was 5mm acrylic that I was just able to process at the slowest speed. Maybe a second pass would have helped to free more rectangles. Thinner material should be no problem though. Engraving is not a problem. Another notable thing is that as soon as you uploaded one job on the BMO, it's saved in storage. Using the screen, you can select all jobs and even adjust laser power and speed. Great if you need to do things over and over. Last, there's glass, also a material that doesn't work with the common blue diode lasers. The BMO is not able to cut it, and probably also more powerful lasers are not the right tool to cut glass, though what works great is engraving your own patterns with it. The laser creates micro cracks at the location where it's at and can therefore texture it. Great for displays and, if you have the rotary attachment, also for individualizing glassware. If you'd like to see the cutting performance on other materials, let me know in the comments. By the way, you can find detailed photos of all of the tests that I already made on my website. Wood engraving worked flawlessly, and line engravings came out really nice and clean with no overshooting marks that I feared due to the belt system. Let's now quickly talk about the air purifier, the Beam Air. In the beginning, I had it hooked to my machine, but since I have it in a pretty small room, there was still a quite noticeable smell I wasn't comfortable working next to. I'm not 100% sure if that's normal or if I'm just picky, but if you use a laser engraver in a confined area, I'd rather vent to the outside than using one of these filters. Though if you have a bigger shop, it's still probably a reasonable piece of equipment to filter out nasty particles and odors out of the air. Just never use one of these without any filter or external exhaust. I ended up cleaning a bit of workspace and put the BMO on a table next to a window out of which I'm able to vent. So what's my verdict, and is the BMO worth its $1,500 to $2,000 price tag, especially if you can find other CO2 lasers at a quarter of the price? First, the BMO laser cutter slash engraver was since quite a while a machine that just worked flawlessly out of the box. Easy setup, user-friendly software with presets, and what I enjoyed the most, integrated test patterns. The software and hardware ecosystem just works and is worth so much if you need it for production. Cutting and engraving, even though not capable of working on really thick and dense materials, worked better than I expected, and I can see plenty of uses for decorative applications or model building. Here I have to highlight boxes.py, a Python library to automatically generate a ton of different box patterns for laser cutting and even usable in your browser. The thing that might be a downside for some is the small working area of only 210 by 300 mm, but here you would have the option to upgrade to the more expensive Flux Beambox or Beambox Pro. The availability of upgrades for metal engraving or rotary engraving are great. They even sell an autofocus module that, well, as the name suggests, sets the laser focus automatically, but also lets you move the focus position downwards during cutting passes for deeper cutting. So $1,500 to $2,000 is a steep price tag, but what you're getting seems to be a reliable tool with dedicated, well-working software and resellers all over the world providing support if you ever needed it. What you should also consider is the safety aspect. This machine is bearing the CE conformity marking, has safety measures that the laser is only able to turn on when the lid is closed, making it a class 1 laser, and also has an exhaust system. Most diode lasers don't have that, for example, which makes them potentially harmful and not suitable for a production environment. If you have a small business or don't want to tinker and use something productively, it might really be a great and especially compact tool for you. Just take a look at the products that are, for example, sold on Etsy that were made using machines like this, be it own designs or just individualizing products for customers. If you're creative and have good ideas, I think you can quickly calculate your return of investment. For my part, I'm really happy with the BMO. The only thing that I'm a bit upset about is the working area, but to be honest, I don't know if I would have had the space for a bigger machine anyways. Just as a disclaimer, I received the BMO for free as a review unit, though all thoughts are my own and no money has exchanged hands. Let me know your thoughts about this machine and CO2 lasers in general down in the comments. A great tool besides 3D printers and CNC routers, or an overrated piece of equipment. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you're all doing well and enjoyed that review. If you want to learn more about 3D printing, then make sure to check the rest of my video library. If you want to support the channel, consider becoming a patron or a YouTube member, or just use the affiliate links in the description. I hope to see you in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and goodbye.